In this video, we're going to have a look at some of the additional features of the note mode and the step sequencer that were introduced in 9.62 and 9.7. So before we start, please make sure that you've updated to the most current version of Live. In my current project, I have an analog device loaded into track number 4. If I press the scale button, I can change the key using the buttons above and below the display, or by using the second encoder, I can change the scale. I can also change the layout of the push pads. Currently, the layout is set to fourths, and I can change this using the first encoder. So with the layout set to fourths, what this means is that I can play the fourth interval starting on the second row of pads. And with the layout set to thirds, I can play the third interval starting on the second row of pads. And the third mode is sequent, which means that you can play 8 pads from left to right before moving to the next row. Not only can you change the layout of the push pads, but you can also change the direction in which you play them. Currently, they're set to vertical, meaning that I play from left to right. I can also change the direction to horizontal, meaning that I play from the base of push towards the top of push. Let's reset all these parameters and have a look at some of the new features of the step sequencer. In my current project, the fixed length button is already flashing, meaning that it's activated. Currently, the fixed length has been set to 2 bars. What this means for the melodic step sequencer is that when I enter the notes into the melodic step sequencer grid, the current clip will be set to the same length as a fixed length, which in this case is 2 bars. Another new feature is setting the length of the actual notes that you've put into the melodic step sequencer. To do this, you simply hold down the note and press another pad to set the length. Another feature is the ability to copy and paste notes that you've put into the melodic step sequencer. To do this, you simply hold the duplicate button and select the note. This has now been copied, so I can now move to another section and paste it. Let's do that for the other 2 notes as well. Not only can you copy and paste the notes to the same positions in another part of the clip, you can also change the position and the pitch. Another feature of the melodic step sequencer is changing the actual length of the clip. You can change the length of the clip to uneven measures as well. To do this, simply press the clip button and hold down the shift button while changing the loop length.